I'm Kimberly Arusha, Managing Director of the USGA Green Section. I'd like to welcome you to How It's Done. These presentations summarize methods and procedures observed by Green Section agronomists as they visit golf courses throughout North America. We are not suggesting that the procedures depicted are the best or only means of performing a particular task. Our goal is to share a broad variety of methods so that golf courses may benefit from the ideas and techniques.
Hello, my name is John Foy, and I am the director for the Florida region of the USGA Green Section. In this How It's Done presentation, we will review steps utilized on a daily basis for maintaining the precise cutting action of putting green mowers to achieve top quality of cut and the best after-cut appearance for putting surfaces. This daily mower maintenance regime is utilized by John Patterson, Equipment Director at PGA National Resort and Spa in Palm Beach Gardens, Florida. John has successfully used this procedure for many years to provide optimum after-cut appearance, which he stresses is job one for his department. In addition to maintaining the equipment fleet for five golf courses at PGA National, where the PGA Tour's Honda Classic is hosted annually, John was instrumental as the president of the International Golf Course Equipment Managers Association in the development of the real height of cut gauge highlighted in this How It's Done presentation. Putting greens are mowed on a daily basis, placing a premium on quality of cut and after-cut appearance. This is true more so than ever before, with putting greens being routinely maintained at extremely low heights of cut of an eighth of an inch or less. Very sharp reel mowers are also needed for maintaining healthy turf. Lucas Harvey, Director of Agronomy at PGA National, and John Patterson work very closely together to make sure that the top quality conditions are maintained. Step one is to clean the mowers. Grass clippings and other debris accumulate on reels and bed knives and mowers every time they are used. After routine cutting of the putting greens, the operators wash off the mowers and then they are staged outside the work area to dry. Each unit is then brought into the work area and any remaining debris is blown off with compressed air before quality of cut and height of cut are evaluated. Step two is to inspect the mower, reel, and bed knife. Maintaining premium mowing quality requires very sharp cutting reels and bed knives. Sand top dressing and normal use of mowers causes the blades to become dull. Also, reels can become misaligned during daily mowing. Quality of cut is evaluated using a strip of paper held between the reel and the bed knife. The reel is then turned to cut or shear the paper against the bed knife. Technicians look for a clean cut of the paper with no rough edges or tears. If the paper strips are not cleanly sheared, the mower is scheduled for grinding of the reel and bed knife to restore sharp edges. Step three is to check and, if needed, adjust the height of cut. The height of cut settings can become altered from daily use. Mr. Patterson uses the real height of cut gauge to check the height of cut and maintain precise settings and consistency among the mowers. There are several tools available to check height of cut on mowers, but as already mentioned, Mr. Patterson prefers the real height of cut gauge. The manufacturing and machine processing of this tool provides repeatable and accurate measurements within one one-thousandth of an inch. The tubular construction also eliminates flexing of the bar that can affect the accuracy of height of cut settings. This gauge is available from the International Golf Course Equipment Managers Association for about $275. For more information on the gauge and the association, go to www.igcema.org. Step Step 4 is refueling the mower. Technicians refuel the mowers and make sure the cap is properly secured. This avoids problems with mowers running out of fuel or fuel leaks injuring the turf. The final step is to park the mowers in designated positions within the maintenance facility so that they are ready for their next use. In summary, daily reel mower maintenance includes bringing in the mowers and blowing them off, visually inspecting the reels and bed knives, followed by evaluating the sharpness and quality of cut of the blades. Then the height of cut is checked and adjusted if necessary. And to do this, as already emphasized, a reliable gauge is the key to accurately calibrating reel mowers. Finally, the mower is refueled and parked in the designated location for use the next day.
This has been a USGA Green Section How It's Done presentation. For more golf course management information, visit www.usga.org and select the Course Care tab.